हेलो 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 माइक चेक चेक हेलो 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 माइक चेक चेक हेलो हेलो
not coming. No, no, I see nothing coming. Music is coming.
Thank you. Arthur. तुम्ही तिथे आम्हाला पोढील जवळ आपण माईक चालू करायला पाहिजे. माईक चालू करायला पाहिजे.
May I request band to be on one side, and I request all the university officers to come in front. That's it there, behind NSS team, yeah. And all the teachers, university officers of HRKC, Bombay Teachers Training College, and non-teaching staff members, kindly come forward. गणतंत्र दिवस समारोह में उपस्थित एचएसएनसी विश्वविद्यालय के ऑनरेबल प्रोवोस्ट एवं आज के मुख्य अतिथि डॉक्टर निरंजन हिरणदानी का एचएसएनसी यूनिवर्सिटी की तरफ से हार्दिक अभिनंदन. हमारे बीच ऑनलाइन उपस्थित हैं एचएसएनसी बोर्ड के प्रेसिडेंट डॉक्टर किशुमन सुखानी, हमारे ट्रस्टी अनिल हरीश जी, ट्रस्टी माया शाहानी जी, डॉक्टर लाल चिलाराम जी, एचएसएनसी विश्वविद्यालय के रजिस्ट्रार एवं डीन ऑफ ह्यूमैनिटीज डॉक्टर भगवान बलानी जी हमारे बीच हैं, डीन ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी डॉक्टर उर्मिला जोशी जी, डीन कॉमर्स एंड मैनेजमेंट डॉक्टर पूजा रामचंदानी जी, हमारे डायरेक्टर्स यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफिसर्स, हमारे तीनों कॉलेजेस और स्कूल्स के वाइस प्रिंसिपल्स, टीचर्स, एनएसएस और एनसीसी के विद्यार्थीगण, और हमारे बीच सर्व कर्मचारी जो हमारे आज साथ हैं यहाँ पे, आप सभी का 73वें गणतंत्र दिवस समारोह में स्वागत करती हूँ और तहे दिल से अभिनंदन करती हूँ. साथियों, लोकतंत्र और संविधान का महत्व बताने वाले इस राष्ट्रीय पर्व को उचित सम्मान देने की परंपरा एक प्रेरणा के रूप में निभाई जानी चाहिए. कश्मीर से कन्याकुमारी तक देश को एकता के धागे में बांधने वाला और इससे सबसे बड़ा जरिया हमें देखा नहीं है, और इस ये जरिया देश का संविधान और लोकतांत्रिक स्वरूप बन गया है. विश्व पटल पर भारत को गौरवान्वित करने वाले विकास कार्यों में हमारे समृद्ध संविधान की बड़ी महत्वपूर्ण भूमिका रही है. हमें इस बात का गर्व है कि आज भारत की गणना विश्व के सक्षम सैन्य संपन्न एवं प्रभावशाली राष्ट्रों में की जाती है। आज हम पुनः विश्व गुरु बनने की राह पर निरंतर अग्रसर हैं। एजेंसी विश्वविद्यालय का यह कैंपस भविष्य में संबंधित कॉलेजेस एवं स्कूल्स के साथ सफलताओं का परचम वैश्विक स्तर पर फैलाएगा, ऐसा मुझे दृढ़ विश्वास है। यह कीर्ति पताका आप सभी विद्यार्थियों के ही हाथ में है, क्योंकि वो आप ही हैं जो प्राध्यापकों से ज्ञान प्राप्त करके अपने कौशल से सफलताओं के नए आयाम स्थापित करते हुए विश्वविद्यालय को गौरवान्वित करने का कार्य करेंगे। आज इस अवसर पर मैं विशेष रूप से तारीफ करना चाहूँगी हमारे एचएसएनसी यूनिवर्सिटी के सभी विभागों के विद्यार्थियों के सांस्कृतिक समूहों एवं एचएसएनसी की टीम को, जिन्होंने इस कोरोना काल में भी बड़े पैमाने पर संगोष्ठियों, कार्यक्रमों एवं नियमित गतिविधियों का सफलतापूर्वक आयोजन किया है। आज सुबह ही विश्वविद्यालय द्वारा फिट भारत मिशन की शुरुआत की गई और उसका प्रारंभ हमारे ऑनरेबल प्रोवोस्ट के हाथों से होगा आज के इस वेलकम एड्रेस के बाद। इस एकेडमिक सत्र पर विभिन्न विभागों द्वारा आयोजित संगोष्ठियां हमारे कार्यकुशलता एवं निष्ठा की प्रतीक हैं। इन सभी कार्यों में हमें अपने एचएसएनसी बोर्ड से भी निरंतर सहयोग प्राप्त होता रहता है। आज हम अपने प्रतिभावान विद्यार्थियों एवं वैश्विक चुनौतियों को ध्यान में रखते हुए नवीन पाठ्यक्रम बनाने एवं उसे उचित तरह से लागू करने एवं आगामी चुनौतियों को ध्यान में रखते हुए परिवर्तन करने के लिए पूर्ण रूप स्वतंत्र हैं। नियमित कोर्सेस के अलावा हमने एचएसएनसी यूनिवर्सिटी में एड ऑन कोर्सेस, डिप्लोमा कोर्सेस, पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट डिप्लोमा एवं कई सारे सर्टिफिकेट कोर्सेस की शुरुआत कर विद्यार्थियों के लिए अत्यधिक सीखने एवं अपनी क्षमताओं को विकसित करने के लिए नवीन मार्ग खोल दिए हैं। प्रिय विद्यार्थियों, मैं आपसे कहना चाहूँगी ये सारी सुविधाएं एवं सुअवसर आपके लिए हैं, परंतु इनकी सार्थकता तभी संभव है जब आप सब अपना सर्वश्रेष्ठ देंगे। विश्वविद्यालय के सभी कॉलेजेस एवं सभी टीम आप विद्यार्थियों को सक्षम बनाने के लिए सतत रूप से प्रयासरत रहती हैं। प्राध्यापकों का यह प्रयास होता है कि आगे चलकर आप सबको आप स्वयं आत्मनिर्भर बनाने के साथ साथ दूसरों को भी रोजगार प्रदान करें, ऐसे प्रयास हमारे फैकल्टी मेंबर्स, हमारे टीचर्स करते रहते हैं। इसमें आप सभी को अपेक्षित मार्गदर्शन एवं सहयोग प्रदान करने के लिए हमारे अलुमनाई भी महत्वपूर्ण भूमिका निभा रही है। मुझे विश्वास है कि इस परंपरा को आप भी यूं ही बनाए रखेंगे और आज हम इस अवसर पर एक हमारे इस गणतंत्र दिवस के समारोह पर मैं चाहती हूं कि एक बार पुनः ये प्लेज लें कि हम साथ मिलकर चलेंगे। आप सभी का एक बार पुनः से स्वागत करती हूं, अभिनंदन करती हूं। पर वाणी को विराम देने से पहले मैं आपको ये बताना चाहती हूं कि दिस ईयर इज़ वेरी स्पेशल फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस बिकॉज वी ऑल आर सेलिब्रेटिंग आर आज़ादी का अमृत महोत्सव। एट अवर एचएसएनसी यूनिवर्सिटी वी आर सेलिब्रेटिंग द आज़ादी का अमृत महोत्सव विद ग्रेट एनर्जी एंड एंथुसियाज्म। डॉक्टर निरंजन हीरानंदानी सर, मैं आपको बताना चाहती हूँ कि हमारे सब कॉलेजेस, हमारे स्कूल्स आज़ादी का अमृत महोत्सव का सेलिब्रेट करने के लिए बहुत सारे कार्यक्रम कर रहे हैं और ये सब कार्यक्रम की एक लिस्ट हमें हमारे ऑनरेबल चांसलर के ऑफिस तक भेजनी है कि ये पूरे साल भर अगस्त 2023 तक जो हम कार्यक्रम करेंगे उनकी पूरी लिस्ट हमें ऑनरेबल चांसलर के पास भेजनी है। सो लेट मी रिमाइंड यू ऑल वंस अगेन दैट आज़ादी का अमृत महोत्सव, ऑल द एक्टिविटीज विच वी विल ऑर्गेनाइज दे आर टू कनेक्ट यूथ to our nation, its society, and its rich cultural heritage. On this day, our Honorable Provost had a dream, what should we do for fitness of our students? And that's the reason he made it a point that something we start on this day, and he shall announce this big movement, this mission, what HSNC University is taking forward. As you all saw on this 73rd Republic Day, HSNC University, in collaboration with Fit Bharat Soldierathon, had organized today morning at 6:30 a.m. a 73 minutes run in honor of our soldiers. On this auspicious occasion, apart from all of our trustees online and our Honorable Provost, Dr. Niranjan Hyandani, we had inspirational presence of two heroes, India's most motivating heroes. I do not know whether they have been able to reach Major Dr. Surendra Punia. Has he reached from the site where we had the 73 minutes run, and Shilpa Bhagat. These two members, Indian heroes, they have taken the lead and have organized this marathon, soldierathon for us, and with the vision that to make every Indian fit and healthy asset of our nation. And this mission aligns with the mission of our Honorable Provost, and hence we thought this will be the befitting day to celebrate the same on 73rd Republic Day celebration of HSNC University Mumbai. Once again, gratitude to each one of you for joining this morning. Thank you so much, and keep celebrating Republic Day year after year with that vigor, with that zeal and enthusiasm. Jai Hind. I request our Honorable Provost to address all of you and address all the students and members who have joined online. Dr. Niranjan Hiranandani, sir.
Well spoken. So, heartiest congratulations to each and every one of you on this 73rd Republic Day. Very sentimental, because when we started this entire board, we had Principal Vidyasagar Kudnani, Ochan Advani, and others, including my father, Dr. Hiranandani, who participated in a new birth of a new destination called education, which we did. So when we celebrate Republic Day, I think the pride moment is that we are proud of what we have done in these 73 years. And each one of us should be proud of that. The birth of any new country, a new nation, and others always is a starting point, because nobody knows how this is really going to move forward. But we have seen that our country, with its democracy, with its president, has really gone fast forward. And this is something which really we cherish. So birth of a child, a birth of a board, the birth of 14 colleges, and now the birth of the university. A birth of a university similar to the time when we had the birth of our board and the first colleges was in the time of chaos, because we just got independence. And the forefathers who really, founding fathers who really set up the educational institution, set a bedrock of a new aspiration of saying, this is what we want to achieve, give education to a lot of people and set up world-class institutions in our country. And this is the product that we are beneficiaries of. So I am very proud. I'm sure each and every one of you is very, very proud of being part of this institution, and congratulations to each and every one of you. This is where it's very important. My Vice Chancellor, my heartiest congratulations to the deans and the principals, the other principals who have come over here, the teachers, the heads of departments, the vice principals, and of course, the worthy students. I think all of you deserve the congratulations, because it's the interaction between all of us together which is really going to bring about the new teaching learning process, which is changing so rapidly. The Prime Minister brought in during chaotic times an NEP, 2020 of a change in the education policy. Again, brought it after 35 years, a new policy, and in a time when there was chaos, but we got the birth of a new policy. During the time of COVID, we also got the birth of our university. There was a big question mark. How are you going to have birth of a new university during COVID? But even Krishna was born in a jail and achieved a lot in spite of everything, that the circumstances of one's birth and the situation that we really have. So I think we don't have to look at the timing of this particular birth, but we got to cherish the fact that we did get this opportunity to set up the university. And as the Vice Chancellor has just told very, very clearly, that there is a big aspiration in our minds. Like the birth of our nation, like the growth of our nation, we are very proud. Look at the wonderful students over here who marched so fittingly over here. My heartiest congratulations to all of you of the wonderful thing that you are doing. I'm really very proud of you. I'm sure some of you will reach Republic Day one of these in the following few years, and I'm sure you will be fit enough to be chosen at that location. This is something which we all have to aspire for. Why have we set up a new university? Is it because we don't be satisfied with Bombay University? The answer is no. We are very proud of Mumbai University, and we cherish all the activities that are done by Mumbai University, and 13 of our colleges, 14 of our colleges still continue to be affiliated, including the existing colleges, with Mumbai University. But when you have birth of a new institution, you create a new opportunity and a new pedestal. And the idea is to take off to the moon, not just to fly high at 35,000 feet, but actually to take off education into the new space that we are doing. And that is the reason why we are extremely happy, very proud, and very grateful to our president, Mr. Kishu Mansukhani, Mr. Anil Harish, Maya Shani, Mr. Chelaram, all of us who really said, yes, let us go ahead with a new aspiration model. A challenge, of course, to us, because we've just started with 3 colleges, while Mumbai University has 800 plus colleges under its fold. So how are we really going to aspire? But we said, doesn't matter. We may be lean and thin, but we are going to be very strong, firm, and aspire to reach the moon. And we'll just be HSNC University, which will take off to the new levels of aspiration, along with the rest, in order to see that the aspiration of each student, each teacher, is met as far as education is concerned. And that is why we enjoy the new birth. When you have new birth, you have new hope. When you have new hope, we have to work towards creating and converting this hope into a direction. Again, this was mentioned by the Vice Chancellor in various ways that we are looking forward to do. In that, we are extremely grateful to the government of Maharashtra, to our Chancellor, to all the other people, the teachers, the deans, all the other parts who are part of the university, those who are part of the colleges, all have participated to do that. But the issue does not end over there. Unless we don't have a vision which is tall, where are we going? If you don't know that you're going to Delhi, will you fly north in order to reach there? The answer is no. So hence, we are all working together, with you and me together, in order to create that vision and say, this is our aspiration model. We want to see that the best education in the entire world comes from HSNC University and the board. We should be second to none in the next couple of years. We want to aspire to reach there. And with the help of each and every one of you and all the powers that be, I'm sure, with the blessings of God and our founding fathers upstairs, I'm sure that we will be able to reach somewhere where, after a couple of years, we can say that not only are we great on this day, and where we have aspired and done in the last 73 years, but also in the next 5 years, 3 years, 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, the aspiration will be to still fly further, higher and better. It is with this pride, with this hope, with this aspiration that we all work together in order to reach this destination. So I'm really happy to be over here on a physical presence and also in the online presence at this point of time in order to share with you my joy of the Republic Day, of this function which is offline today, and also to state that we are all working together in order to reach the moon. And we definitely will work together in order to achieve it. And once we are on that track, I'm sure with all your help and cooperation, we shall and we will. So I wish you the very best on this Republic Day. In fitness of things, if we want to aspire to reach the moon, if we really want to do it, we need to be fit. We need to be physically fit. And hence, today, we are very happy that the Fit India mission is also carrying out the run for 73 minutes. And we had a very proud moment when one of our deans also did it this morning. He put me into shame. I thought I should actually race with him, but I can tell you, please, please. So Principal Balani did that this morning. Next year, I think all of us should do it. Oh, the students have already come. So my heartiest congratulations to the students who did that. So wonderful, 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 really, to see that you have participated. So you got to be physically fit. And if you're not physically fit, you won't have the energy in order to do your work. You won't have the capability of really doing it. Because life is about energy, fitness, and time. Time is with the Almighty. But energy and fitness depends on you. Hence, the idea of the Fit India mission, in order to get each and every one of us, including myself, they thought I was so unfit, they brought a chair for me. But I don't need one as of now. Maybe sooner or later I will, but at this point of time, I'm fit to run the 73 minutes and beat most of them. So I'm really looking forward to fitness. Fitness, of course, has different connotations. Fitness in terms of physical fitness, which is what we are talking about. But fitness can be mental fitness also, emotional fitness also. And all these factors the university has, we have empathy for our teachers, we have empathy for our students, we have empathy for people and the economy. We have to have all this empathy that must go around in order to make a complete university. A university cannot just be about growth and direction and education. It must have the fitness part of it important. And each one of us must grow, because our children, grandchildren, and others have that hope and aspiration that we will create educational institutions which will help and enable them to reach the moon. And one day I hope that the students from all over the world, just like had happened in the good old days with Nalanda University, for more than 1500 years, India was a leader in education. It is our aspiration, and I believe the Prime Minister's too, that we in India will become the education center of the world and be proud once again of this. So with this pride, I wish you a very happy Republic Day and my heartiest congratulations on this beginning of Fit India movement, and hope that all of us will participate in it. Those who are not fit, and most of us are not completely fit, so I encourage you to start getting into a fitness regime for the physical fitness at least, and then we will talk about it in the other part of the fitness that we really need to do. So congratulations, and I wish you all the very, very best to you. Thank you. Come.
Sir, thank you very much for that inspirational, motivational address to all of us. Now we request you to unveil and inaugurate the Fit Bharat Mission with Fit Bharat Club. Friends, I'm so glad that after that 73 minutes run, our two heroes are here with us and they could be part of this inauguration unveiling of the club at HSNC University. So may I request Dr. Surendra Punia and Ms. Shilpa Bhagat to join us. Let me share with you how this started, and this is just a couple of days back. A small interaction, a talk, a conversation with Dr. Surendra Punia and through Dr. Shilpa Bhagat. We had this small conversation, what should we do? And they already shared with us their mission for Bharat, Fit Bharat. So the inspirational presence of these two heroes who are motivating heroes for India, they are here today. A big round of applause for them. Major Dr. Surendra Punia, the founder of Fit Bharat Soldierathon. Friends, I want to share with you that today we have joined hands with them, and who are they, you must know. Major Dr. Surendra Punia, he was awarded with Vishisht Seva Mandal Award on 26 January 2012. He is the first Indian athlete with the rare distinction of having won medals in powerlifting athletic events in four consecutive world championships. He's alumni of Armed Force Medical College, and he was commissioned into the Army Medical Corps in August 2001. He served the President's bodyguard, Rashtrapati Bhavan, New Delhi, as a medical officer. Dr. Punia is a keen sportsperson, medal winner at college, university levels, as well as a qualified paratrooper. A warm welcome to you, Dr. Punia, and lot is written on my sheet. Let me also welcome Ms. Shilpa Bhagat. She's gold medalist from JU and MBA in finance, a leadership student from Harvard Business School, Boston. She started her career as a banker, but chance to win at Mrs. India World 2013, and thereafter she carved out a different path. Both of them, this Fit Bharat is a brainchild and passion project of these two highly driven individuals. So warm welcome to you, HSNC University. And I believe this university is the first university and the first institution where this club is being inaugurated and has been launched through the hands of Dr. Niranjan Hirandani, who is himself a fitness icon. As I mentioned, that Fit Bharat vision and this mission is all about making every Indian a fit and healthy asset of a nation. And today I take pride and I'm very proud that we could be part of that mission and shall see to it that every student, every individual of this country is fittest one. So thank you so much, Dr. Surendraji and also Shilpa for making it to come here. I thought I missed you. I sent a message where you have reached, but I could see that you were in time. Thank you so much. And once again, congratulations for starting such a great mission, and we are with you at every step and we'll work together, seeing to it that this becomes our vision for making every individual, every citizen of India, the fittest soldier and the fittest commander. Thank you so much.
Honorable Principal Saiba, Hiranandani sir, Sara staff aur yahan maujood Hindustan ka sara bhavishya jo samne hai, aap sabhi ko mera Jai Hind kabul ho, Jai Hind. Pehle teen baar hum Bharat Mata ki Jai bolenge, awaaz itni buland honi chahiye ki Rawalpindi aur Beijing tak aapko aapki awaaz jaani chahiye. Bharat Mata ki Jai. Meri akele ki awaaz aapse zyada hai. मैं कह रहा हूं रावलपिंडी और बीजिंग तक आवाज जानी चाहिए आपकी. भारत माता की जय. भारत माता की जय. मैम शुक्रिया. आप जो एक पूरे हिंदुस्तान में एक बड़ी चैन शुरू होने वाली है उसकी पहली कड़ी आपके यूनिवर्सिटी से शुरू हो रही है और आपने हमें मौका दिया कि हम आपके बच्चों के साथ आपके इंस्टीट्यूशन के साथ ये जो हमारा जिंदगी का एक मिशन है वो हम यहाँ से शुरू करें. मेरा ये पर्सनली मानना है, मैंने सेना में सर्व किया स्पेशल फोर्सेज में, वहाँ मैंने एक चीज़ सीखा कि सैनिक वो नहीं है सिर्फ जो सरहद पे लड़ रहा है जिसके हाथ में गन है. सैनिक सिर्फ वो नहीं है, सैनिक जो यहाँ खड़े हैं ये भी सैनिक है. आप सिविल सोसाइटी के सबसे बड़े सोल्जर्स हैं. वो लड़ाई बहुत आसान है, वहाँ हमें दुश्मन सामने दिखता है, हमारे पीठ के पीछे कोई दुश्मन नहीं होता, लेकिन सोसाइटी के अंदर जहाँ हम रह रहे हैं यहाँ हर तरीके की जो कमजोरियाँ बुराइयाँ सोसाइटी में हैं उनसे लड़ने के लिए आपको सोल्जर बन के हर जगह खड़ा होना होगा. और ये एज ए स्पोर्ट्समैन ये मैंने एहसास किया है मेरी ज़िंदगी में, और इसीलिए हमने ये मिशन शुरू किया. जब मैं डॉक्टर कलाम के साथ काम कर रहा था तो उनका कहना था कि इस देश को कौन बदल सकता है, इस देश को सिर्फ और सिर्फ युवा पीढ़ी बदल सकती है. जब भी कोई मेरे को कहता था कि मुझे डॉक्टर कलाम से मिलना है, और मैं जब उनके पास जाता था कि सर ये अपॉइंटमेंट तय करना है आज आपसे, ये मिलना चाहते हैं, तो वो हमेशा एक चीज़ पूछते थे, उम्र क्या है, उम्र क्या है उसकी. तो कुछ दिनों बाद में मैं तंग आ गया, मैंने कहा सर वो मिलना चाहते हैं, आपको चाहते हैं, आप हर बार उम्र क्यों पूछते हैं. तो उन्होंने कहा कि जिस आदमी की उम्र ज़्यादा हो गई उसको चेंज करने में मुझे बहुत ज़्यादा डिफिकल्टी होगी, लेकिन जो यूथ है उसको आप किधर भी मोल्ड कर सकते हैं, अगर उसको सही रास्ता दिखा देंगे तो वो इस देश को इतना खूबसूरत इतना मजबूत बना देंगे, और अगर उनको कोई रास्ता नहीं दिखाएगा तो वो शायद भटक जाएंगे. तो हमारा ये मिशन कि इस देश को फिट बनाना है, हेल्दी बनाना है, और ये मानना हमारा कि एक हेल्दी आदमी, एक फिट आदमी, एक खुश आदमी और एक देशभक्त आदमी, वो इस देश की सबसे बड़ी ताकत है. ये चार चीज़ आप याद रखिए, एक हेल्दी आदमी, एक फिट आदमी, एक खुश आदमी और एक देशभक्त आदमी, वो इस देश की सबसे बड़ी धरोहर है, और आप इस देश की सबसे बड़ी धरोहर हैं. हमने जो मिशन शुरू किया है हम चाहेंगे कि सिर्फ यहीं तक ना रुके, आप अपने पड़ोस में, अपनी कम्युनिटी में, अपने बड़े छोटे, उनको जब भी टाइम मिले आप सुबह शाम घर से बाहर निकालिए, उनको उनको कोई फिजिकल एक्टिविटी करवाइए, क्योंकि इस देश के अंदर 140 करोड़ लोग हैं और 140 करोड़ लोगों में से 30 करोड़ लोग हाइपरटेंशन की गोलियां ले रहे हैं, 25 करोड़ लोग डायबिटीज़ की गोलियां ले रहे हैं. ये वो लोग हैं जो डॉक्टर के पास जा रहे हैं, लेकिन इतनी सारी जनता ऐसी भी है जो डॉक्टर के पास नहीं जा रही, जिनको पता ही नहीं है कि उनको ये तकलीफ़ है. 55 करोड़ लोग अगर रोज़ाना सिर्फ 100 रुपये की गोली लेते हैं, आप याद रखिएगा एक बात, तो तो रोजाना का 5,500 करोड़ रुपए इस देश का खर्च हो रहा है. कितना? 5,500 करोड़. चलो 5,000 मान लो, तो महीने का 1.5 लाख करोड़. शायद हिरानंदानी सर जो हैं यहाँ पे वो समझते हैं कि इस 1.5 लाख करोड़ की क्या वैल्यू होती है. और पूरी साल में 18 लाख करोड़ रुपए की सिर्फ दवाइयाँ वो क्यों खा रहे हैं कि वो एक्टिविटी नहीं कर रहे. अगर वो बच्चों के साथ, बड़ों के साथ, किसी के साथ भी अगर एक्टिविटी करने लग जाएं, ढंग का खाना खाने लग जाएं, कचरा खाना छोड़ दें, तो वो खुश रहेंगे, अपना उनका परिवार खुश रहेगा, हेल्दी रहेगा और आसपास का माहौल ठीक रहेगा. किसी भी कॉरपोरेट में भी अगर आप जाते हो तो वहाँ के जो फिट लोग हैं उस कंपनी का जो माहौल है, उसकी प्रोडक्टिविटी है वो बहुत ज़्यादा है. वहाँ काम करने का मज़ा ही अलग है. इसलिए मेरी आपसे एक गुजारिश है, मैं फिर आऊँगा मैम यहाँ पर, आपके इन सभी साथियों के साथ मैं बैठूँगा और हम डिस्कस करेंगे. ये वन वे कम्युनिकेशन नहीं होगा. मैं भी आपसे सीखूंगा कि हम कैसे इस मिशन को पूरे देश में लेके जा सकते हैं, क्योंकि जो आइडिया मुझे हैं मेरे से ज़्यादा आइडिया आपको भी पता है. मैं हो सकता है कि कुछ एक आइडिया से आ रहा हूँ कि ये करना, लेकिन अगर आपके आइडिया अच्छे हों तो हम उसको पूरे देश के गाँव गाँव, गली गली, मोहला मोहला, हर कॉलेज, हर इंस्टीट्यूशन में, हर कॉरपोरेट, हर जगह लेके जाना चाहते हैं. इन्हीं शब्दों के साथ कि आप खुश रहें, आपका परिवार खुश रहे, आप सब लोग फिट रहें, आपका परिवार फिट रहे, हिंदुस्तान आबाद रहे, हिंदुस्तान जिंदाबाद रहे. जय हिंद, जय भारत.
I just want to say one thing, a big, big thank you to all the volunteers who actually came up this morning at 5:30. They were all there wearing their white t-shirts and they were helping around. Literally, there was this one boy who actually dirtied his jacket, poor guy, because he was serving. And I said, Mummy ko kitchen mein khana banwate ho ya nahi, but here you've come down to help us. I'm really, really proud of you. So guys, thank you from the bottom of my heart. You guys were rock stars. You guys actually made our event so successful. Thank you guys, thank you.
Respected Vice Chancellor Madam, respected Professor, all the dignitaries, all office bearers, Madam has given me an opportunity to announce and remind everyone that one of our NSS volunteer and first HSNC University's NSS volunteer will be marching on Rajpath today, and we all can witness it at 10:30. It was a difficult task because of the COVID conditions. The number was reduced from 200 to 144 at Delhi for 1 month training. And actually, out of those 144, only 80 candidates will be marching on Rajpath. So we are proud and we are thankful to HSNC University, Professor, Vice Chancellor Madam, all the colleges for encouraging our volunteers to go ahead. And for KC College, one more thing which I would like to mention, that she will be the 9th candidate who will be marching on Rajpath during last 15 years. Thank you. May I request Dr. Balani sir, registrar of HSNC University, to come forward for vote of thanks.
Good morning to one and all. First of all, happy 73rd Republic Day to one and all. Honorable Provost Dr. Niranjan Hiranandani, Honorable President Mr. Kishuman Sukhani, Mr. Anil Harish, Mrs. Maya Shani Ma'am, Mr. Lal Chelaram, Mr. Vandan Agrawal, thank you for giving us wonderful institutions, Constitution Colleges, HSNC Board Colleges, and now HSNC University. Thank you for giving, accommodating us in this, in your family, HSNC family, by creating these world-class institutions. I'm also thankful to Vice Chancellor Madam Dr. Himlata Bagla. Under her leadership, we are taking our university's objectives forward. The way she has been working very hard, more than 16 to 18 hours a day. I believe that, and the way she inspires each one of us, all the stakeholders, from management to the students, to the alumni, to the industry, and everyone, she takes everyone together. I believe that the kind of collaborative work that has been done at HSNC University is tremendous. And I am the fortunate one who has got the opportunity to work under her leadership. So ma'am, thank you. Thank you for always guiding all of us. I'm also thankful to my colleagues, Dr. Pooja Ramchandani, a very strong pillar of support, Dr. Urmila Joshi, and all my colleagues at HSNC University and in Constitution Colleges, vice principals, teachers, university officers, and the most inspiring students. I was inspired today to run for 73 minutes early in the morning, and I believe that the credit goes to Mr. Punya, Dr. Punya and Dr. Shilpa Bhagat for associating with HSNC University, organizing a wonderful event, and I was the first beneficiary, I must say. So I must thank to both of you all. And I'm also thankful to you for collaborating with us and helping us in setting up Fit Bharat Club at HSNC University. And I believe that the brigade, the young brigade of NSS and NCC students, they will undertake many more activities on a regular basis. And I think as far as the flag of HSNC University is concerned, we'll take in each and every corner of the world. Sir, we promise you. We promise you that HSNC students will reach not only to the every corner of the world, India, but they will reach to the every corner of the world. So students, I believe that the way you have been working, the way you have been getting involved in the processes, I believe that you strengthen yourself, but along with you, you are strengthening our society as well as our India. I'm thankful to the wonderful audience today. I think the government of Maharashtra has declared that the colleges should be open from 1st Feb, but I believe that the HSNC University has taken a lead and has opened the college and the university campus for all its stakeholders from 26th day today onwards, after the post-pandemic. So please clap for yourself. And the kind of resources that we have got, please make use of all the resources that we have got. Be there in the classroom on a regular basis. Please try to be participate in all curricular and extracurricular activities, especially sports. And I believe that we are going to create so many opportunities for you to grow to optimally as far as your own potential is concerned. I'm thankful to all the staff members of HSNCU, all the teaching, non-teaching staff of HSNCU campus for organizing this, especially Mr. Manish Karale, Assistant Registrar HSNC University, for doing all these arrangements with colleagues. Please have a huge round of applause for all the staff members of HSNCU, including Mr. Manish Karale, Mr. Pranav Vagal for designing the standees and brochures and really creating a wonderful environment at HSNCU. Thank you all for being there. Have a nice day, have a wonderful, and have a fantastic and blessed day. Thank you all with your blessings.